Hi everyone, Monica Moore here, nurse practitioner at Illume Fertility, and today we're going to talk about medications that you use. And I feel like the best way to do this is to put them into categories. So I'm going to use the whiteboard, and we're going to talk about the different meds that you use during an IVF cycle. So the first step is to pause and coordinate. When you come in to start a cycle, we don't want all of your eggs growing at different rates. We want them to grow at relatively similar rates. So we need to kind of pause and reset things then in order to make that happen. And we do that by using either birth control pills. Sometimes we use Lupron, and sometimes we use esterase or estrogen. And like I said, that just allows the follicles to be paused at around the same stage or size, so that once we use the next set of medications, the stimulating medications, that they can all grow around the same size at the same rate, so that we don't have what's called follicular disparity, or follicles growing at different sizes, one big, one middle size, one small size. And when we go to retrieve them, that gives us those different sizes would potentially make it so that we have more immatures than we want. So the next set of medications is the stimulating meds. The stimulating meds will act on your ovaries to make a certain amount of follicles every month. You pull from your follicular reserve. Women are born with the most amount of follicles. The most amount of follicles or eggs that we have are actually prior to we were born. And that amount that we have is finite, so we use a little bit of it each month. So each month, your ovaries will pull from that reserve and decide that month how many follicles or eggs are going to be pulled from your reserve. So what we want is, instead of just one being dominant and mature, which would happen in normal menstrual cycle, we want to salvage as many of those that are pulled from your reserve that month as possible. And we do that by giving you stimulating medications early on in a menstrual cycle, prior to that big or dominant follicle formation. So the name of the stimulating medications are Follistim, Gonal-F. These are essentially the same medications, but different drug companies. If you get one or the other, it doesn't mean that one is better. It means that your insurance covers one more, and we want to kind of save you some money, so we do that. Menopure, which many of you will be on. And if your insurance doesn't cover Menopure, then we do a medication called low-dose HCG. These are medications that have a hormone called FSH. These are medications that have a hormone called LH. This also has FSH. Menopure has both. And so together, FSH and LH, which your body would normally make every month, will give you the best, or hopefully most robust response in terms of how many follicles or eggs we're able to salvage that month, so that you don't just make one. So now that we make all of these great follicles or eggs, we don't want you to ovulate them prior to going to retrieval. So we have to give you a medication that keeps you from ovulating. That could be either Lupron. It could be a medication called Gonorelix, and or Cetratide. Like Follistim and Gonal-F, these are the same medication, but just two different drug companies. Lupron, we would give you prior to when you have a dominant follicle, because it needs a little bit of time to work to suppress. So you would take that longer and for more days. If you're on a protocol that uses Gonorelix or Cetratide, those medications work right away. We would start those as soon as you have a follicle that is closed or a possibility for ovulating, usually around 14 or 15 millimeters. So once you have a dominant follicle and seems like your lead follicle or lead follicles are mature, what we need to do is to give you a medication to complete the maturation process, and the medication would ovulate you in 36 hours. So what we do is we precisely time this medication and your retrieval so that your retrieval is about 35 hours, so that your follicles are as mature as possible, but have not ovulated yet. They haven't left the ovaries yet, so that we can retrieve them in a retrieval. So this is called either a surge medication or a trigger medication. And the most common of these is HCG. Oops, I spelled that wrong. HCG goes by a lot of names. One is chorionic gonadotropin. The brand name is Pregnyl. Another one possibly is Avadryl. The likely scenario is if you're doing IVF, you'll get an HCG or HCG derivative. That is one of the medications that's very precisely timed. Your retrieval is based on that time. So we want you to take your HCG at that particular time, and it's really important. Should you get embryos back that cycle, as opposed to freezing them or having genetic testing done, then we need medications that prepare your lining of your uterus, what's called the endometrium, the lining of the uterus that responds to medications. And those medications are estrace, prometrium, progesterone in oil, or endometrin. These are all progesterone. This is estrogen. And what normally happens in a menstrual cycle is the optimal combination of estrogen and progesterone make your lining suitable for implantation of an embryo, which is what we hope. If you go on to freeze embryos because you're freezing for some reason or to have genetic testing done on the embryos, you won't do this step in terms of preparing the lining until you do your frozen embryo transfer cycle. So hope that's helpful. As always, please reach out to us with any questions or concerns. Thanks so much.